One of the first things you do when you are doing a smart car motor is you take off these skirts, because they're going to give you a lot more access. Take off the tires first, then take off the skirts. Some people call them inner shields. I just call them skirts. Take them off on both sides. You got a clip here, really hard to get to sometimes. They don't like coming out. But you got to pull that center piece out first. And then a couple of them have bolts. You got, or nuts, I mean. You got a nut here, nut there, and nut there. And you got a nut behind the phone. But that's what you start on a smart car when you do the motor first. At least that's what I do, because you're going to drop the whole subframe all together. And here it is, final product. I already done one, so I can prove that I know what I'm doing, or that it's not that hard, should I say, since I did it right. But you can do it too. So I'm just going to raise the car up and give you a couple tips on where to, what bolts and things to do. You got flashlight. You don't have to take nothing loose back here. There's one bolt here for the frame, one bolt there for the frame, and that's it in the rear. Now, you got to take off this shield right here, of course. It's a two-piece shield. Once you take this back piece off, you don't have to worry about the rest. Then you got brake lines and ABS lines. You got the other frame bolt there. You got the other frame bolt there, that rusty one, if you can see it. Oh, my flashlight's in the way. You got that one. So you only got four frame bolts, but you've got these hoses. See these hoses right here? These hoses right here, they're really hard to get to. So it's better to move the starter out your way, and it makes it easier for disconnecting the e-brake also. It's really, see this little center piece right here? Little metal tab right there. There's a metal tab in there holding in the middle. You can pull that down, that'll help you disconnect the parking brake easier. I didn't even drain the oil on the old one. I should have. But like I said, it's pretty easy. You got one wire, one major power wire that goes to the starter and is connected from the starter to the alternator. You can reach the alternator bolt from the top, unbolt it, and it's got a couple clips that hold it in place. And after that, it's got electric power steering, so you don't have to worry about that. All right, hopefully that gives you a heads up on motor swap. Doing the motor swap on this one because the compression was very low, like 30 and 50 pounds in all cylinders, which is the head, because you put transmission fluid in it and never built up. So it's the head that lost the compression. But I lost a seal, should I say? And there you go. I'm trying to think of some other pointers that might help you out. The fuel line is pretty easy. You disconnect it from the top and just pull it out the way. You got a connector on this side. Once you get this skirt out, you can see this is me. This is the back of the motor. This is the front. If it was in the car, you got the connector on this side. And you got a connector on this side that comes from the car up. You got a connector on this side. And then those are the two that you disconnect. And after that, it's pretty easy peasy. Hopefully that helps you out. Disconnect these AC lines, makes it easier. Here's the parking brake. You can see they're still there. You just leave everything on. I disconnected a couple things I didn't need to, because it's the first time I did this one, but it'll be okay. I had to loosen this motor mount to get this transmission linkage off, gear shifter. But other than that, it's pretty easy. There you go. Hopefully you've seen something that you need to know, and it's helping you out. Give you an overview. Where's the okay. Just give you an overview. Maybe there's something you need to know about this motor that you're missing. You don't know what it is, so just give you an overlook of everything. See, Here's the fuel line. You disconnect it right there. You disconnect the wire here on the start on the alternator. It connects here at the starter. Connects at the starter, comes over to the alternator. Well, you have to pull that cable out, otherwise you'll break it. And you don't want to have to fix a major wire. The starter switch wire is all contained in this area, so you don't have to worry about that one. Just the one wire that goes to the starter and the alternator. It's a big black wire. Nothing else. It's easy peasy. Just drop it down with everything. All right. Hope you like this video. Thank you for watching.